Also rifle and bullets. How you like that, bitch? Cool. Someone's looking up. Ow. I need to reload. I'm working on it, I'm working on it. Gotta figure out some shit.
The only good thing about this goddamn horrible situation is that I'm not allergic to birds. Ah, shoot!
I got some more? Oh, shit. I like that, bitch.
Open the door now.
Oh, we're gone. Oh. All right, cool. Barry's still alive.
Hey, Al.
Yes.
I'm sorry for thinking you were having a psychotic episode, man.
It's okay, man. You didn't know.
I sent Barry to the town to ask around about a man fitting the kidnapper's description. He'd go through the archives of the local paper. Perhaps he could learn something. Anything about the island and the cabin that had disappeared. The man wanted a manuscript. I had to try to write him one to get Alice back. For me, the supernatural had always been nothing but a metaphor for the human psyche, a tool to use in writing fiction. Now, it was happening for real, and I couldn't put a single word on paper.
Barry Wheeler speaking.
This is Rose.
Rose?
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Oh, you sweet, brilliant girl.
Could you and Mr. Wake come get them? I live in the trailer park outside the town.
We'll be there in less than an hour.
I know.
See you soon.
Have a great day. Hope you come back soon.
Welcome to the Old Deer Diner.
Good girl.
Tell anyone except my agent, Barry.
Damn it, Barry, they'll kill her.
You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head.
The ransom is a manuscript I supposedly wrote that's coming true before my eyes.
It happened just the way it was on that page. So dark.
I have found only a few scattered pages.
I want the entire manuscript.
The deadline is in 2 days.
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Good girl.
How the hell did she get her hands on the manuscript anyway?
I don't know. She's resourceful. I told you you were too hard on her.
Listen, I found out all sorts of interesting stuff while I was digging around.
Yeah.
Mr. Wake, it's Sheriff Breaker. We have an FBI agent here, Agent Nightingale.
FBI?
He's anxious to see you. You'd better come to the station.
Okay, I'll be right over, Sheriff.
Let's make this quick, huh?
Help you folks? Name's Randolph.
Hey,
I'm the manager.
We're looking for Rose. Works as a waitress down at the diner.
Rose, sure. Nice girl. Who wants to know?
I'm Me. Alan Wake.
Bitch.
The writer, huh? I heard on the radio you were visiting. Well, I'll show you her trailer. That Rose, she's a nice girl. Always pays her rent on time.
As I was saying, Al, I found all sorts of weird stuff from the local newspaper's archives. This place is crazy. Disappearances, mysterious deaths, urban legends come true, and get this, most of this stuff takes place around Cauldron Lake.
Well, you ain't wrong, mister. The Indians thought the lake was a doorway to the underworld. I'm the God-fearing type myself. I don't hold
I ain't fighting Indians.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, there was an island there owned by a
Damn,
guy called
I'm sorry,
Thomas
bud.
Zane. Now, some of the articles I found about him make him out to be a famous writer, but I ran a bunch of searches, couldn't find a single thing he wrote. Zane was heavily into diving, so much so that the place came to be called Diver's Isle. But the volcano under the lake erupted in 1970, and Zane went down with the island.
Yeah, how about that? It was there in the morning, as if it had fallen from the sky. But it would take a tornado to lift something like that. We're damn lucky it didn't crush any of the trailers.
That's fucking wild.
Jagger drowned in Cauldron Lake just a week earlier. They were lovers.
Sure, Jagger's a local spook store. The scratching hag comes for you in the dark. Childish stuff like that.
Anyway, Al, I'm just getting to the best part. All of the articles about this stuff were written by Cynthia Weaver. I asked around, and she's that crazy bag lady you met.
What, the lamp lady? She can be a little loopy, but she's not homeless or
Yeah, anyway, she knew both Jagger and Zane before they both died,
and
she had some kind of a breakdown.
Randolph and... Randolph.
Well, mister, this here's Rose's trailer. You mind me asking what you want with her?
We're just here to talk to her, pal.
To Oh dear, Mr. Wake, I'm so glad you're here.
Rose, you have my manuscript?
Oh yes, please come in.
Barry, you don't oh my gosh, she's so broken.
Hey, this is really good.
Rose.
Yes.
My manuscript. I really need it.
I understand. I know what you need. A muse to inspire you.
Oh, for Barry? She doesn't have anything.
Yeah. Hey, Al? Al, what's... Oh.
Barry! What? What?
It's coming for you, hiding in my barber's skin. I'm too weak to stop it. You must turn the lights on.
I promised I'd come visit you and your lovely wife. You must finish what you started. I insist.
You must turn the lights on. Turn the light on.
Back to work, boy.
I felt nauseous, hungover. Only anger kept me going.
I can't tell reality from dream anymore, but it seems I have an imaginary editor to help me. She's an old woman in a funeral dress. I call her Barbara Jagger. She's very strict. I'm writing faster and faster. My manuscript is being heavily revised. The edits are getting very aggressive, and each day there's less of me and more of her. I hate it, but I know she's right. She promises me I can save Alice this way. She knows more of this than I do. About the complex incantation I'm attempting. About this place. She's worked with another writer under similar circumstances, Thomas Zane. The genre of the story seems to be shifting. It's turning into a horror story. I'm getting close. I can feel it.
Rose took a day from me. I had less than 12 hours left to meet the kidnapper. All I could do was get Barry into the car, work something out once I got on the road.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner. What can I get you today? Coffee?
I couldn't work up much hate for Rose. Something had used her to get to me and left its mark.
First refill is free. Milk and sugar on the counter there. Would you like to hear today's specials? Thank you. A nice day. Come back. Soon.
Barry is just out.
My gun and flashlight were gone. I'd have to find a way to get Barry into the car as quickly as possible. There was no time to waste.
This sucks. I guess that looks promising.
Oh, you're gonna get it now.
What'd I do?
God knows what you've done to that poor girl.
This is Agent Nightingale, FBI. Get him up, Hemingway. You're under arrest. You move a muscle, I'll unload right in your goddamn face. Stay right where you are, Blaine.
Right here, you goddamn maniac.
The fuck do we do?
I hated to leave Barry behind, but there was no way I'd miss my appointment with the kidnapper.
Look, Barry's gonna be safer. Oh, fuck. Go. Yeah, Barry's gonna be safer with them. Are you fucking serious?
Oh,
fuck.
Damn.
Come on, dude, back your stamina. Come on, dude. Leave your stamina, come on. You gotta go. We gotta go. Oh, that's cool. Good time to catch your breath.
He's gone. Come on, guys. We need to head him off.
Get this up. Get up. You know, when those shadow people will probably come out to attack them, they're going to be like, oh, he dropped out some monsters. They're attacking him. Shit like that. Wow.
This horror was everywhere I went, circling me. The cops didn't stand a chance. They were after a writer, not a monster.
Good. Should be something out here for me, hopefully.
Deputy Mulligan, over.
Well, whatever. Anyway, Rose is just being plain weird here. You better get Doc in to take a look at both. Over.
Gotcha. You better get them here quickly. The Fed's gonna want to interview Wheeler, over.
Oh, yeah, I bet he does. Looks like they have a lot in common. Mulligan out.
He's got a gun and a phone.
I imagined that the broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station. Maine seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine. Unnatural shadows clung to the gate. The darkness that was after me was trying to stop me. I wouldn't get through without a light. There was no power to the searchlight.
What the fuck is he doing here, man, huh?
Generator conked out. I'd have to see if I could fix it and try again. It took me a moment to recognize the flashbang grenades. They were an ideal weapon for my situation.
FFM with Pat Maine.
It's Milt Peabody, Pat.
What's on your mind, Milt?
Well, I live near the trailer park, Pat, and there's a big ruckus going on over there.
Well, that's just up the road from me, too. What's going on, do you know?
I don't know, but there's a bunch of police cars there, lots of sirens, a helicopter buzzing around, and I think I heard some gunshots.
Gunshots?
Yes, sir, like from a pistol. So can you find out what's going on? Because it's just next door and they're popping off guns there.
They're still shooting?
No, it was maybe 10, 15 minutes ago. It sounds serious, Pat. I'm telling you, it don't sound like no party.
I'm certainly going to give the station a call, Milt.
Okay.
You'll hear it here as soon as I hear from them.
Okay, thanks.
exactly what I needed. Some good old stuff. Hopefully it's a gun in here. Some more flare.
I hope Maine could lend me a car to get to the coal mine.
Thank you very much for that compassionate viewpoint, Lorna. Oh, here's a little surprise. The famous writer Alan Wake just walked in, folks. I'm gonna see if I can talk him into an interview.
Come on in, Mr.
Oh, I'm so glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
Nowhere to run now, Dan Brown. You back away from me. Don't hurt.
Whoa. Everyone calm down. Put the gun down. We're all friends here, right?
Cool your jets, Nightingale. We got him.
Jesus, priest!
What the hell's the matter with you? There's a civilian in there.